hit me with a bat. It feels like I got a friggin' horse kicking it.
I never should have gone alone. Amateur move. I should have handled those pricks. Goddamn dirty Cali rat bastards.
Those cocksuckers beat me rotten, left me for a stiff. I had to crawl to my car, crawl my ass up here. The vamp blood's the only thing holding me together. But shit, they got the money, they got the astrolite.
Vamp blood?
Right, you're straight off the bus. Once a month I get fed vampire blood. Heals me faster, makes me stronger than a normal human. I don't age. By looking at me, you wouldn't realize it, but I'm almost 60.
Okay, so then Mercurio from Redemption is a entirely... because Mercurio's a vampire, straight vampire. So then no tie-in. Okay, scratch that. Pull the nail out. Now my floor is covered in blood. Ooh, Acvi. Hospital, maybe? Depending on, like, how big was the nail? Where do I find the astrolite now? Did you learn anything in that all that time, genius?
Hold on. You think I'm some amateur? I got their number. Small-time sons of bitches live out in a dump on the beach. Maybe four or five of them. The one's got the explosives is Dennis. Got my money too, that prick.
Wait. This is a... he's a ghoul. I thought ghouls rot. Maybe it's different? Not a big one, but long. I've done that before, and I hope you don't have to get a tetanus shot, dude, because I've had them before, and they hurt.
Laying in a pool in my own blood, and you want friggin' directions. Right, all right. Down the street, in the parking garage, stairs down to the beach, on the right. Those better not be some of my last words.
Anything else?
You gotta get it back from him. Maybe reason with him, maybe break in. I don't know. I want to kill him. Do whatever you people do. I blew it, I know.
Anything I can do to help you? Don't go anywhere, Slick. I'll be right back as soon as your job... I do the job for you.
One more thing. About the deal. I mean it. You tell anyone about this, I'm dead. I'm begging you. I got a way of getting people what they need. You don't say anything, I can help you out.
Maybe is there a way to ease your pain?
Yeah, if you could... oh, something just started leaking. I need something for the pain.
You know, I actually did have... I have painkillers.
Oh, holy Christ, I needed that.
All right, you're welcome. I'll come back with the astrolite. And we got humanity. Does that mean that I can go act? If I accidentally have to bite somebody a little too long, can I bite somebody a little too long? All right. So let's take a look here. Bondsman, Arthur, Santa Monica Suites in apartment 1. Hollywood Downtown Chinatown. Mercurio asked you to retrieve the astrolite he was supposed to get from the group of junky pricks who live in a dump on the beach. Additionally, Mercurio will get his money back. So, hold on. Do I have to keep a track record of what they say? Because I'm like clicking on this bounty. And now your character knows that feeding a human blood heals wounds. Hint, hint. Oh! Right, yeah, there we go. Okay, let's go heal her up. You'll get to see your grandma. How do I feed her blood? Or will it just change and allow me to do it anyway? Wrong way. Kiddo, I'm coming. Drink, my child, drink. Wait, do I have a goal now? Like that? Best cure in the world, baby.
You... Who are you? Oh, what did you do? What did you do to me?
I gave you cherry flavor cola. Simply wanted to help.
But you did something. I kissed your wrist. I can feel it inside of me. What did you do?
Let's go with number two.
What? Doctor! Security!
That was a bad option. I saved your ass!
Who are you? Can I help you with something?
Just passing through. Wait, I saved her. I am terrible at this.
That was
okay, hang on.
Yeah. What? I got...
Oh, oops. I think I hit the wrong button. I did. Okay. I'll save Mercurio. I'll save Heather, and then I'll walk away. I was hoping for a ghoul chat.
Those mother... Alright. Right. Hold on. Land in a pool. Gotta get... One more... Yeah, if you could...
Okay. Okay, there we go. F5. Sorry, F9. Now we're good. Alright, let me go do... Real quick.
Check. Is this thing
okay, Carson, where did you go exactly?
Anyway, the McGee case is getting weirder all the time. I found where he's been hiding and I saw some really creepy stuff down there. There was no sign of McGee. I'm going to follow up on another lead I got, too. I updated the files on the computer. This is Carson signing off. Man, that sounds stupid.
Control C. A password for strange Carson. Strange. Weird. Password. Oh, wait a minute. Tattoo parlor key. Parlor, maybe. No? Hacking is at 1, and that requires wits and computers. We could get... Let's go ahead and get 1 in computer, and then I'm going to try to focus in on everything else. So, we'll make sure to get stealth. Control C. Man, I wish it actually told me the actual password. Wait. Amelie is the password? Really? McGee. Location. McGee's hiding in the tattoo parlor in Santa Monica. Key. Don't forget the key to the tattoo parlor. It's on top of the TV. That's it. All right, that's fine. Let's go save the kid. I'm not gonna leave her behind. Wait until you were done hacking. Looking behind the sofa on the wall, you'll understand. Oh, Biscuit. Really? I gotta check now. I gotta be more observant. That's it. Damn! Okay. That's the sort of game this is gonna be. All right. I get it. I understand it. We're good. All right, tattoo parlor is Devil's Brand Tattoo down the street. For Twitch, don't ban me. Don't ban me. I went the wrong way. Oh, that really leads to Rome in this game. Multiple roads lead to Rome? Really? Oh, we got a crime scene. Somebody done broke it in. Right? Oh, can't pick that bad boy up. Justin, you down here, buddy? Is he hacking people? Like, I think so. Quick cash for modeling. Call Gimbal's Prosthetics. Snips up here. Snips up there. Mush, mush it.
Hello. Might I speak with Mr. McGee?
Doesn't seem to be here at the moment. Can I help you?
Well, I'm not sure. I had an appointment with him a few days ago, but he never seemed to show up. Do you know when he'll return?
I don't know, actually. What sort of appointment was this? No, actually, I'm looking for him myself.
Well, Mr. McGee was going to be doing some modeling for me. Medical reference for the work that I do here in the studio. It's a shame, really. The proposition would have been quite lucrative for him.
Really? Maybe I could come down and model for you.
Why, yes, that sounds delightful. Perhaps you could come down to my studio and we can sort out the details.
I feel like he's going to, like, try to hack limbs off. Sounds good. Where are you located? A little while. That's sketch. Yeah, okay. And down we go. Saw Gimbal over in the corner. Hello?
Yes, may I help you?
I'm on a blood drive. I could use some sunblock. Wait. I'm on a blood drive. I could use some sunblock. Okay, sorry. Gotta check.
Oh, right. I'll buzz you in.
Apparently he does not have sunblock. Who knew?
Hello! Welcome to Gimbal's Prosthetics and Medical Supplies. You're here for the modeling job? Good. You seem to have rather well-developed limbs, if you don't mind me saying so.
Well, thank you. And who are you?
Oh, yes, forgive me. My name is Gimble. Stanley Gimble. But, oh, dear, let us dispense with formalities. You can call me Stan.
Nice to meet you, Stan. I'm ready to get started if you are. Tell me a little about yourself, Stan.
Me? Oh, I'm just trying to make things a little easier for those who find themselves disadvantaged. Giving a helping hand, you might say. A leg up. Bloody clever, that one.
Yes. Wow, you're really funny. Can we get started? You seem disadvantaged yourself.
You mean the arm. Yes, that's an interesting story, if you've got the time for one.
I'd love to hear it, Stan.
Well, you might say I have a certain love affair with the human anatomy. An obsession, really. Prosthetics seemed a natural occupation in which to focus my enthusiasm, as it were.
Hey, sometimes you gotta get that self-pat. Yeah, you can't give yourself a high five because it just looks weird. And your arm?
Well, I came to realize that I would never truly reach mastery in prosthetics without knowing what it was like to have to use one.
Wait, you didn't. Right, go on.
And so I decided, quite out of the blue actually, to cut off my own arm. My work, as you can well imagine, has quite improved since then.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Now that is dedication. Can we take some pictures now?
Aha, an eager participant. Very good. Just give me a few moments to get my equipment ready, and then come on in and we'll get started.
So, off with his arm, chat. Cannot say while in cutscene. I'm in cutscene? That was a cutscene? Medic- Oh. Shit! Acme, you wanted mannequins, you bastard. Mannequin arms and other parts, $26.50. All mannequins on sale, $125. Prosthetic limbs, varies per customer. Crash test dummies, $14.50. Crash test dummies, love that TV show back as a kid. Love the toys too. Amputees must wait up front. Well, this got. This limbs, prosthetics, and mobility aids, Stan Gimble. Everything was so nice up there. Where most of the budget probably went, because this just looks like a hacksaw. Yep. I will take the blood pack though. Thank you for the free meal. Appreciate it. Why do you have a recording? Danny boy! Oh, Danny boy, the... Yep. He still might be a decent person. And exactly. Say too much, too quick.
Huh? Oh, hey, help! You gotta get me out of here, man. This guy's a freaking nut job.
Who, Gimble?
Yeah, Gimble. That guy's been taking pieces off of me and McGee over here for the last 3 days. He's crazy, man. Freaking crazy.
I don't believe the voice actor saying he freaking crazy, man. He freaking crazy. He gonna get me. Okay, now how do I open the store again?
What are you doing here?
Oh, hi! Real quick. Let me bite you, you bastard! fine. You know what? You jerk.
Thanks, man. You're a lifesaver. I wasn't sure I was gonna make it. I'm telling you, I've been on some weird cases, but this one takes the cake.
Apparently took, I think, your arm.
Yeah, that's me. How did you know?
Arthur.
He did? Oh, man, that's solid. I owe that guy big. I hope I can figure out a way to get him back for this.
Got some work for you, so you should head back to the office.
What? Oh, no, man. No. Not for me anymore. Look at my hand. Gimbal took my trigger finger for a trophy. I'm all through with this business. I hate to leave Arthur in a lurch, but that's just the way it is.
Man, you ain't no fall guy. Later. You hear that dark barking? I think it's Old Yeller. I'm out of here. I understand. I'll tell him the... I want to go with Old Yeller?
Thanks again. Don't worry. I'll take care of Old Stumpy here.
Yeah, better come back with the place. Wait! Oh, foo! On the ground. Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Hey, Stumpy! Stumpy. Ah, damn it. I shouldn't have done that. Wait, do we not? I can't get in to nibble on Stumpy? I am offended. The big question was Mr. Gimbal using his own arm to bite you, to hit you, or were the arm of the dead and the guy in the cell? I think, well, hang on. Well, oh, damn it, the body's gone. I think did he hack off only at the joints? At the elbow? Or did he hack it off at the shoulder? Because it looked like he had hacked off his arm at the shoulder or the elbow, and he was using a full arm. So, well, no, he hacked that guy off too. Could be a trophy spare. All right, if we check here. You rescued Carson from the clutches of the drain. Stay in Gimbal. Or back to Arthur. Maybe it was a full arm. Yeah. So then, I think it had to be that arm. He kept it as a memento. Couldn't quite part with it. I can understand that. I can respect that. All right. Now, let's go back to the bounty hunter. We'll let Carson know, or Arthur know about Carson. Then we'll go take out the boys from Mercurio. We're over here.
Hurry on your way to the apocalypse. Always room for heathens in the cold and oily pits of the damned.
I feel like if I nibble on this guy, people will see.
What's shaking?
I found Carson. Unfortunately, he's not coming back.
What? Ain't coming back? What do you mean he ain't coming back?
His trigger finger got cuffed by a freaking psychopath.
Man, that's a tough one. Bounty hunter ain't no good without his trigger finger. Well, hell, that really leaves me in hot water, boy. Gonna cost old Arthur real good.
What's the problem now?
I got this guy with a sheet a mile long, put in on 3 warrants. His girlfriend put up for the bond, and now he missed the court date. I can't get in touch with either of them. Want a job?
You haven't paid me for finding Carson yet.
Oh, yeah. Sorry about that. Here you are.
Okay, thanks. And about that job?
Well, it won't be much of a job since you ain't licensed and all, but until I can get me another bounty hunter, I need you to find out if this guy's
200 bucks? Not bad. So you just want me to find if he's out here or not, right?
Yeah, no body attachment or nothing. Just find out if he's here or where he went. I'll pay you. Deal?
I suppose I could do that.
Great. All right. The guy's name is Mike Durbin. Goes by the name Muddy. His girlfriend put up for his bond. She lives over there above Tripp's pawn shop. Her name is Marion Murrieta, but I haven't been able to get in touch with her.
Do you know where I can get a gun or two? What's this guy's record like?
Well, he was brought up on manslaughter charges years back, but he got acquitted. Since then, he's been in and out for this and that, small-time stuff mostly.
Wait. What did he do this time?
Most recently, he was brought in as part of a big case on stolen auto parts. It's this big chop shop thing that's going on in Santa Monica. Been in the paper.
So, above the pawn shop, right?
That's right. Marianne Murrieta, in them crappy places above the pawn shop. Find out where the hell Muddy is, where is he going, whatever. But be careful. You're not licensed, and if anything bad goes down, I don't know you. You hear me?
Yeah, I hear you.
All right, come.
See you soon. Wait a minute. Hang on. Did you, recently, Hey, he replenished yet. Man, you can really, really rely on Arthur to be just plump and ready to go with blood. That there is an easy snack. Okay, so we gotta go to... Bakura asked me to retrieve the astrolites, on the beach. Okay, so how do we get to the beach? If I wanted to go to the beach... The beach is... I am here, so...
Sorry.
Oh, here we go. Just looking around. If there is any snacks nearby, alone, isolated. She's not really isolated.
I've seen a lot of shocking things in my time on the force, but that pier, that's the kind of thing that makes you lose your faith in humanity.
I gotta say, it's the second worst thing I've ever seen.
Poor bastard.
I just want to let me in.
By the looks of it, you think someone tied him to two horses and raced them in opposite directions.
Damn.
What could you have possibly seen that was worse than what's down there?
It was about 3 years ago up in Malibu. Found this guy on the beach. Looked like, I don't know, an animal attack.
Shark bite?
Nah, I've seen shark bites. This was something different. Like whatever killed him knew what he was doing.
Does that sound like Adam? Jensen?
There were these huge slashes, but...
Bullshit.
And I'm wondering if that's Adam Jensen.
Guy was literally slashed to ribbons. Wagon. I felt like something was watching me. I swear on my badge today that there was something just out of sight. And for a split second, I thought about running to the squad car and getting the hell out of that place. To this day, it makes me wonder what's really out there.
Maybe it was a werewolf. Woo!
All right.
Or a vampire.
Get it. See, this is why you didn't get invited to Hernandez's wedding, Ted.
Oh, poor Ted. Which now that makes me wonder, shit, are there werewolves in this game? Better yet, are there werewolves in the other game? Because we only encountered ghouls, zombies, and vampires in Redemption. So far, anyway.
Up there. Through that chain link gate and up those stairs.
Wait, who are you? What?
Those men you are looking for.
Oh, this isn't Twilight. No, they don't sparkle. Yeah, they don't sparkle. How did you know I was looking for someone?
Never mind. You wouldn't understand.
But I would like to understand. Weird. Well, that's what's new. Thanks. Sounds about right. Strange is, a strange does. Wooden stake. Up the stairs we go, chats. So my understanding is Bloodlines 2 will take place in a similar location as this, as Bloodlines. So we'll be able to see all of this in modern, like, graphics engine. Which, if that's true, man, that's gonna be kind of cool. Hey, man, how you doing?
Help ya.
Relax.